Peter, if you would you talk to us, assuming I can get the video working, do you think that the General Assembly this year is going to weigh in on the development of drones for commercial and news gathering purposes?
Sure. Thanks, Holly, and thanks for being here. I thought if it's possible that one way to introduce this subject might be to give you an example, which we have here, of some of the news work that's being done with drones. We've got two leaders in this technology in the news area in Atlanta. CNN has done a great deal of work with drones. It's worked with Lockheed. It's a pathfinder under the FAA's program. WSB has gotten exemptions for drones from the FAA, and this is an example of some CNN footage of the South Carolina floods last fall, just about a minute long. That's it. Thanks. You can just pull the plug on that. So the General Assembly does appear to be poised to weigh in on the use of drones in Georgia this year. There were a few bills introduced last year that didn't go anywhere. But the House set up a study committee, and that committee held a series of meetings last fall, and it's resulted in a bill that was introduced earlier this month by the subcommittee and its chair, Kevin Tanner, a representative from Dawsonville. It's House Bill 779. That bill is in the process of being tweaked, but I'm told the general sense is that it does stand a significant chance of getting passed. Probably not in its present form, but in some new iteration we've not yet seen. The bill's not so much aimed at where you can fly a drone. That's a federal airspace issue that's governed by federal law. And Representative Tanner told me that he made a very conscious effort to avoid any conflict with that and has worked with the FAA to come up with a bill that he thinks they basically have signed off on. So it's not a bill that's going to have the kind of no-fly zones that we got from the Georgia Building Authority that they tried to impose last year around. Like, they came out with a rule that said you can't have a drone within 5 miles of the state capitol. This bill doesn't try to do anything like that. What it focuses on instead is what's much more of a traditional state law issue, which is what you can do with the drone. So here's what this bill provides, and it provides kind of an odd set of things. First, you can't use them to hunt. you also can't use them to interfere with or harass hunters. You can't weaponize them, so it would be a crime in Georgia to put a weapon on your drone. You can't use them to obstruct law enforcement or emergency medical work. So it has those kind of provisions. More important for what we want to talk about this morning, it would also regulate what sort of images, and it's not just photos, but it's also what else you can capture with a drone, which is sound. There's a lot of security concerns about what sort of, you know, if you get a drone into somebody's Wi-Fi, private Wi-Fi, if you can invade their privacy in that way. So it regulates the what sort of images and data you can collect on a drone and what you can do with that data. Much of the bill is directed at things that I don't think raise issues for the media or for private citizens, and they're really more of a libertarian bent. The bill tries to restrict, has a number of provisions restricting what law enforcement can do with drones. When they have to get search warrants if they want to use a drone to conduct surveillance. And it also regulates what sort of drone imaging can be done by other government entities and by quasi-governmental entities like, utilities like the Southern Company, when they can use drones and how to control their lines throughout the state. What's relevant for First Amendment purposes, though, is that it also regulates what drone imaging can be done by private citizens and by the news media. So what does it do in that area? First, it doesn't, the way I read it as it's written now, it doesn't seem to limit taking images with drones of public property. So that seems to be generally not regulated by this bill. But what it does substantially regulate is the images you can take of private property or individuals on private property with drones, other than private property that you yourself control. So the general basic provision in the bill, and again, I think this is likely to change, but the way it's written now, it says that without permission from that private property owner or the person who has control of that private property, taking any image with a drone of that property or an individual on it would be a crime under this bill.
Even from a public place.
So even if the drone is on the above the street, or even if the drone is above your own property, if you are taking an image of private property that you don't own or you don't have permission to take drone images of, this would make it a crime. So to give you some examples, under current law, that's not the current law. You can take pictures from public property, from your own property, as long as there's no reasonable expectation of privacy by the person you're taking the picture of. And generally, there's no reasonable expectation of privacy if you can take an ordinary non-magnified photo from a place where you have a right to be. There's also a general recognition in current law that if something is going on property that you don't own and that might ordinarily have a reasonable expectation of privacy, if there's something going on there that's a matter of legitimate public concern, you can take a photo of it and not violate any law. So this bill, by changing that and making just sort of a per se prohibition unless you have permission, would be a significant change. So here's a kind of frivolous example, but let's say my neighbor is holding a Klan rally in his yard. I can stand on the street with a regular camera and take a picture of that. But if I have a drone I'm operating that's in that same place, even if it's not using some magnified image or anything of that sort, under this bill that would be a crime to do that. Plus, and here's a further unusual provision of this bill, it's not just a crime to take that image, it's also a crime to knowingly possess or distribute any image that was taken in violation of the law. So for example, if I photographed the Klan rally with a drone on my property, you know, without any magnification, and emailed that video to CNN and said, you know, you should use this, it'd be a crime for CNN to broadcast it if they knew it was taken in violation of the statute. And it would even be a violation for CNN to possess that video if they knew it was taken in violation of the statute. So those are obvious problems that the bill has. I think Representative Tanner understands that those are problems. And there are folks with the movie industry, with CNN and others who are working with Representative Tanner to kind of try to come up with language that would address those problems. You know, there may even be new language within a week or so, but we'll just have to stay tuned to see what happens. I would say that there is a lot of pressure on all sides to try and come up with a solution. First, there are some areas of the bill that are clearly, that don't have anything to do with this media, private citizen, First Amendment issue that I think go in favor of doing something, the law enforcement regulation, for example. There's also a lot of pressure to come up with something that's statewide, like this bill, because what's happening is various municipalities are trying to come up with their own drone rules. That makes it more difficult. I think there's a sense, the study committee certainly had a sense that drones, they don't dislike drones, they actually like drones. They think it's actually a great business for Georgia to be in with all the aviation business that Georgia has now. So drones are seen as a good thing. There's a sense that they would like to create a model statute that might even be useful elsewhere in the country. So I think there's, you know, people are working to see if they can come up with something, whether they can do it, and whether they can do it in time to have something done this year, I think is a substantial question. One last issue with that is that it also raises some open records issues in the sense that there's a presumption in this throughout this bill that if images were taken in violation of its restrictions and law enforcement has them or anybody has them, they should be destroyed. So I think the sense is if law enforcement has taken some of those and you make a request for it, you know, I think the bill's authors think, well, that shouldn't be an issue because law enforcement should be, they're under command to destroy those records.
Other questions? Go ahead, sir.
Peter, of course, this is about the drones. And just what you think the prospects are on, because I would see putting an end to that proposed legislation. As far as the restrictive nature of it, where would you maybe see it going?
I think it's going to change a lot from what it is now. So I think the sponsors recognize that if something newsworthy is happening, something of legitimate public interest, you know, for example, that flooding video, then certainly the media should be able to photograph that and display it and get citizen videos of it and use those as well. I think it's just a question of what the language is going to be like and whether they can come up with something. But it sounds like if not, again, I think the sense of a lot of people is that it's likely something will go through, but it's probably going to be a lot better than what it is right now.
Yeah, sir.
I also want to ask about the drones, because, you know, obviously it's a very impressive tool for the media.
Right.
And I really appreciate your desire to form a template that other states could follow. That would be great. But to that end, wouldn't it be more elegant to create a regulation that says what you can photograph as opposed to what you can't photograph?
Well, in fact, the statute does, and I think part of where it runs into problems is that it does try to do that. So it's got a list of things and people who can do drone use and what they can do it for, like for fire suppression, for, you know, if there's a disaster, government's allowed to go in and use drones. But the problem is, you know, there are always things that are unexpected that come up. So what's the general standard that applies where the legislation doesn't really address it? And this legislation currently, the default is that you can't do it. The effort is to try and come up with a default or a more general exception for where something is of legitimate public interest, or where there isn't any reasonable expectation of privacy, that you should be able to do it.
I mean, the point is that the photographers or the people who work for the media would know what they would know more easily what they can do.
Right.
Because it says right here. I mean, there's confusion even now as to the First Amendment when we photograph someone on the street. They say, you can't photograph me. But I explain, this is the First Amendment. We're on public property. So even something as simple as that is misunderstood. This is obviously a much more complex issue. And to approach it on that basis, what you can photograph at least gives everyone a simpler understanding of what you know the law is.
Well, and this is actually worse than present law in the sense that this is a criminal prohibition, and it's got this prohibition about even possessing video that's in violation. So you mentioned possible criminal penalties to people. That makes them, you don't want to be in a gray area as much as you might otherwise.
And so. I guess my question is, how is that different, like, than a paparazzi who, you know, go in with these big, huge zoom lenses and they get pictures of people and all of that, and they're protected?
Well, and that's part of what's going on here in this discussion of alternative language. The movie industry is, California has very extensive anti-paparazzi legislation against drones, and there's some people want to introduce all of that here. I don't know that Georgia really has a paparazzi problem like that. And I don't think the issue, and part of what's driving the legislation, though, is people want to protect. Yeah, it's what you often hear with anything in the internet, that we want to protect people against that guy sitting in his pajamas with a drone who's out looking at the neighbors. I mean, the fact is there are criminal prohibitions now that prevent that kind of eavesdropping.